That's right. We're here at the corner of Broadway and Pierce in Dover, and behind me right there is the house that burned last night. Extensive damage. So incredible that the mother and her four young children, including a baby, got out okay. So many people thankful that Dover firefighters kept it from spreading to other buildings and to police for arresting the person they believe is responsible. Dover firefighters arrived at 28 Broadway just after 9 Tuesday night. A mother and four young children got out safely moments before. Neighbors described hearing screams and ran outside.
The flames were really high. It was really scary.
They're thankful that no one was hurt, glad their homes were spared, and that police have arrested the alleged arsonist responsible.
Oh, I clearly don't want to think that there's arsonists in my neighborhood.
It makes me feel a little better, you know. A little safer.
19-year-old Sean Hoyt, who lives nearby, was arraigned Wednesday. Investigators saw him after the fire, and according to court paperwork, he said he'd been in the garage where it's believed the fire started.
They spoke with the defendant, who indicated that he had entered the residence in, the garage area, and had flipped a cigarette onto the garage floor, which caused the fire to start.
He allegedly said he left to get help, but couldn't find any.
Who do you live with?
Those family members were at his arraignment.
He's got learning disabilities. He just wants to be accepted, but he's always getting picked on.
She says she's just glad everyone is okay. Back near the scene, a neighbor finally sees a picture of the suspect.
Yeah, this is so upsetting. I can't believe I was talking to him. I was sitting there with my dog. I gave him a biscuit to give to my dog.
All, she says, while the fire raged.
He was standing here watching it burn.
That woman, by the way, did immediately call detectives. And we hear that the family is doing okay tonight. Sean Hoyt is being held on $100,000 cash bail. And Dover police do acknowledge that they've been investigating a series of arsons in this neighborhood over the past few weeks, but they aren't saying if there is any connection. Live in Dover, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.